Hey guys, thanks for joining me today for the next video in this series on ingredients that sound harmful but really aren't. Today's video is on the ingredients guar gum and xanthan gum. But before we get started, be sure to like and subscribe for more videos in this series as well as other videos on faith, health, and beauty all year round. So, I know you've seen guar gum and xanthan gum on plenty of foods that you eat. It's most notably found in sauces, salad dressings, plant milks, and even in a lot of baked goods. It's really mixed into a lot of the condiments you eat as well as sweets. And what guar gum and the xanthan gum do, if you're not familiar, is it helps to thicken the texture and keep ingredients from separating. You can actually buy xanthan gum in its own packaging from Bob's Red Mill. So guar gum is derived from the seeds of a bean plant, and xanthan gum is produced when sugars are fermented by certain bacteria. They don't harm, and they really do some good. Both of these gums, as well as mucilages, regulate blood glucose levels, aid in lowering cholesterol levels, and help in the removal of toxins. Now, food sources of gums and mucilages include oatmeal and oat bran, as well as sesame seeds, and beans and legumes. Now, guar gum and xanthan gum also can help you to bring much needed fiber into your diet. Now, per tablespoon, guar gum has 9 grams of fiber and xanthan gum has 7. Again, these are products you can now buy yourself and add to your baked goods, your sweets, if you're making your own nut milk like I do, and you want to add some fiber and help it to be thicker, as well as when you're making your own salad dressings and your sauces for spaghetti and so forth. You can add these yourself, and now you know that they're safe to eat. And if you do see them on the labels, ingredient labels on products that you eat, now you can rest assured that you're not gonna end up having your intestines and anything stuck or waiting for it to come out. You're good to go. If this video has been helpful for you today, be sure to like it. And if you have any comments or questions, be sure to put them in the comment section below. And if you're not already, be sure to like and subscribe for more videos in this series, as well as my other videos on faith, health, and beauty all year round. So thanks for joining me. Stay tuned for the next video in this series, ingredients that sound harmful, but they're really okay. See you next time.